Hey everybody, Scabbard Gaming here and welcome back to Crossout. Today, I'm going to show you a few of the vehicles that you can get from joining factions, and I'm probably going to do a raid as well. So that's plenty. Now, I've been messing around loads in this because I've actually become quite attached to the game. It's very, very fun once you get into fighting other people, and you do that. That is something that happens. No, I mentioned it in a previous video that fighting drones and bots just isn't that exciting. But honestly, you get into fighting people and it just explodes into awesomeness. I'm not winning every battle for a change, which is really good. It actually makes so much difference. Now, as you can see here, I've chucked a couple of blades on the front. I've got three machine guns, which so far has kind of been the best setup that I've seen so far because you get range as well as a fair amount of damage that I'll show you in the test drive. Now, you can test drive any vehicle, even the ones that you haven't got from the factions yet, and you get to blow your own vehicle up, which also allows you to test your armor ability and like how much damage you can sort of withstand, and it kind of tests your weak spots as well. Now, clearly my wheels are a massive weak spot, and the weapons on the front and on the top are very, very easy to destroy. Now, I figured that out. You can also blow off the swords on the front and stuff like that. So if you're trying to cripple someone, not kill them, it's actually super effective to do that. Whereas, you can see, if you try and plow a load of damage into the bodywork, you're not going to get very far before your weapons disable or something worse, like you get killed. So the idea really... Boom. There you go. So I skate back. The idea really is more to disable the vehicle than actually destroying it in one fell swoop, if you understand what's here. Now I'm level 7 now, which means that I've opened up a couple of extras. Now if I go to build, apologies, but for some reason my vehicle is all the way over here. You can see some of my extras in here. Now I got like slope, for instance, a large slope made of container walls, increases vehicle structure, and it's like an indestructible component. It says that, it's not really. I got like minivan parts as well. I got the 76mm cannon. I've got radio, which increases your broadcast for other people, telling them where enemies are. I've got the minivan cab. I've got a 20mm autocannon, which is fantastic, but it doesn't turn very fast. So for my current sort of vehicle, I need to keep moving. I can't stay in one spot because I haven't got much armor. Still got the shotgun, starter, miniguns and stuff like that. So I've got a few more accessories like headlights, which increases reputation gain, which is fantastic once I get into the next factions. Now I'll just show you the factions. I don't want to concentrate too much about gameplay. Now this faction here, this is the one you start with, the engineers, and you can't go to the others yet. Now I don't know if you have to work your way up so you end up with lunatics and then nomads and then scavengers, but their vehicles get more and more obscene. Now, if I just show you one of them, for instance, this bad boy, you can test drive. Look at this machine. It's flipping nuts. And it has a ginormous great cannon on the top. Now, this one fires with a cannon and rockets at the same time. Now, like I say, it takes ages to turn around. And there you go, you got the reticle coming from the right there. Now, if I just fire... That's nuts. So these are the sort of vehicles that you can get later on once you join the factions. Oh, what's going on with those? Oh, so at close range, those rockets do not hit anything, but the big cannon still does. And you can change it so that you're... That's insane. Where are the rockets going? Yeah, and you can change it so that your right mouse button fires one weapon and your left mouse button fires the others and stuff. So these, later on, these weapons and these vehicles are going to be flipping mental. Look at it! So look, you can test drive loads of these. Like, I could test drive the Rock. Now, this is like the best one available for this faction. Look at this thing! It's flipping mental! I haven't got any of these components available yet, to me. So, you got the big cannon. Boom! And then you got these. It's absolutely insane what you're going to be able to get later on. And like every one of them, you've got loads of different manufacturing blueprints as well that you can add later on. Like these melee weapons. I mean, what the hell? Look, so these lunatics, for instance, this is like the first lot that you get. They got these crazy buggies. Now, I've seen these in the game. And I didn't know how people had actually managed to get them. I just assumed that they were like rare drops and stuff like that. But actually, you could probably get them pretty early on. And they do mad damage. Ah, this vehicle is so nimble, which you'd kind of rely on. Just crazy close range sort of shotgun spray. Ah, it's just nuts. So you can see this game has got so much going for it at a later time. I mean, it's a bit of a shame actually that I'm kind of stuck with the engineers at the moment. Now I can build this, for instance. I can test drive this because I'm level 7 with this faction. But this is basically what I'm already running. So there's not much point in me building this up. But I mean, it's flipping mental, isn't it? I mean, this does seem to have a faster... This is a faster vehicle than what I have. So there are benefits to using them, but at the moment, just not for me. So yeah, fantastic stuff. Now if I go home, I wanted to show you a raid. Now I'm going to do it in this, because it's a pretty good all round. So if I go to... I didn't want to test drive. If I go to battle, at the missions tab here, like I've got the cannon. I haven't done that yet. I haven't got the wheels, even though I've already got that. And I haven't got a random stand part either that I've seen off any of this. But raids. We go to raids. Let's do an easy siege. No, I can't do that. One's locked. That one's locked as well. So easy defense it is then. Easy defense. A small raider party is attacking our pump jacks, and we spent so much time repairing and installing them. Protect the jacks from enemy waves. So you do this with other people. So as you can see, there's four of us, and we're doing it on the bridge, drive riverbed. So the idea here is just protect the structures from raiders. That should be doable with people. We're only up against bots at the end of the day. But I did an easy race where you have to go around collecting all of these little supply drops. And that was actually pretty difficult. Oh, sorry buddy, I was actually trying to... Oh, so you've got to get to it first. I thought we were just going to be protecting from there. See, his vehicle's nuts. Look at that. Mental. What level is he? It's a shame you can't really tell without going to the menu. I want to concentrate on the race at the moment. Not race, but you know what I mean. Here they come. I need to get rid of one of his wheels or something. And then his gun. Not from here, I can't. Okay. Any more? So, as you can see there, getting rid of their wheels and then maybe their weapons. So he's probably not worth attacking now. But that guy is. I need you to stop moving around so much. Right, see, there you go. And now he's not defenseless yet. So I got rid of his weapon. Ah! Those guys are attacking. Get rid of his wheels. Ah! See, this is how it's done. You'll band together. Get rid of all of their parts. You don't have to destroy the vehicle straight away. Nah, I'm just hitting my guy. Alright, you've still got a weapon. Okay, fair enough. I get you. Right, so he's gone. Let's see if I can get through his gun. Yep, gun's... Oh, okay. That guy just went straight through him. Right, we've got to get to the other one. I'm trying to reverse, buddy. Sorry. What are you doing? We've got to protect that one over there. Oh, for God's sake. It's because he's missing a wheel. He's struggling so badly. Bless him. But we need to get to the next one in 1 second. Why is my vehicle going so slowly all of a sudden? Still, this is what the raids are about. This is so much cooler than just the randoms that we've been doing. Where'd those other ones go? Ah, there he is. No, you don't. Let's get rid of his wheels. Yeah, now you're useless. Get rid of those things on the front. He's just sliding. I love it. Right, you. Oh, no, you don't. I'm getting rid of your wheels as well. Boom. See what I mean? Just disable them. Ah, yep. Yes. Just in time. Get rid of his wheels. Get rid of his. Right. Once you got rid of their wheels, they're pretty much defenseless. They're just going to sit there. And that's the plan. Oh no, you don't. You know, they can't hit it very hard once their wheels are gone. This wave is mental. There's so many of them. Get rid of his wheels. And his. Get rid of his gun. You're not doing much now, are you? Yeah, there you go. Right, he's defenseless. Don't get me wrong, you don't get as many points for just doing that. It's so much better if you actually destroy them, but at the same time, it's like... Ah, you... Where have you come from? And you have to use this tactic in PvP, otherwise you get mullered. Come on, guys, we've got to protect this one. See, this vehicle is actually pretty tough, because on the front, I've got those plates to protect the bodywork. And as long as I don't get attacked from the back and at the wheels, I'm generally okay. I can take a fair amount. Oh my god, there's loads of them. What the hell just happened? Uh-oh. I'm getting churned up because there's too many here. I'm getting churned up badly. Oh my god. How do I get out of this? I got two wheels. I can't turn. Oh god. Can I still fire? Awesome. Come on. Why can't I? Oh no, my add-on for turning over has been destroyed. I'm just going to have to use the guns. Oh, stop it. I can't do anything. Ah, got your wheels. That's all I can do now, really. Let's just get the wheels. Wherever I can. Well, you're still going down, buddy. Oh no, you don't. Get rid of that wheel. I can still shoot you guys. Yes! Look at this. Even though I'm massively mullered. How about you? Can I hit you? I can. That's quite obscene. Really trying to get somewhere. Car flipped, wait for help. I can't wait for help! It's too late for help. Come on guys, flip me over. Oh, I'm so mullered, it's ridiculous. If they try and flip me over, in all honesty, I'll probably just... You are the man, thank you. Yeah, we can still do this. Let's get rid of this guy. And yeah, looks like we might actually win this. Last one. I took so much damage during that, it was insane. No, that's one of ours. No, don't hit the thing. That's just silly. No, don't hit me. So much damage. Yes, we did it. Regardless of all my wheels. This is good. That's a raid. How much cooler is that? I so much love this. So you don't get a massive amount of XP for actually doing that, even though you get all of these awesome stickers saying how much I did. And you don't get a lot for it either. You don't get really cool random awards or anything like that. So easy defense. That was not easy. But victory. I see, I need more armor if I'm going to do something like a raid, because you just don't... You just take way too much damage in a raid. It's just mental. But how cool was that? That kind of completely obliterates all of my previous sort of, you know, it'd be good with people and stuff like that. Now, if I show you a normal battle, get the wheels, let's do that one. Since I hit level 6, I'm fighting on equal-sided teams. Yeah, you can see he's already winning. It won't take him long. But since I got to level 6, I've started fighting, look, on equal sides, you have players on both sides, and it's just made the game so much better. I look at this guy, he's capturing red, and no one is bothered. Wow, look, he's got it like... How did he... That's insane! He's just put like a plank out the back and he's got like one wheel. How... What benefit could that possibly have? That's amazing. That guy is going to stop you. Well, he would have done. Look, they run out of base. Oh, Nightwolf, you were a little too slow. This guy won that battle. It only takes one guy. Right, cool. So, as you can see here, we've got Nightwolf, Electric, Mischief Star, Doc Basie, Scabbard, dang it. Christopher at the bottom, he's not a real person. Then you've got Ryan at the bottom, he's not a real person. Then you've got Maximilian, Gelby, Fuzzy Pieces, Dead, Zerst, Duggan, and Delilet. And they're all real people. So this is going to be a hard match. Especially since I seem to be like the lowest level person here, or the one with the worst vehicle. It's always the way at the moment. Which is why I've been working so hard to level up and get some really awesome pieces. So I can show you guys some of the best stuff. Now, I don't usually play red. This is kind of a new thing for me. Oh, I'm not, I'm in blue. I'll be white then. Now from here, I can snipe. Yeah, everyone else snipes you as well though. This is kind of why I went with the machine guns. Let's see if I can stop that guy hammering our boys. Yeah, we're on the assault. You're gonna get somebody. I can see you on the hill. Ow! He's got a big weapon, and I just lost a wheel. That's the dangers. That's the dangers. Now, what you've really got to do is you've got to take out their team. It's not just about capturing the base, otherwise they'll eliminate your team before you get down there. Gelby, you're mine. I can't stop myself sliding because I've only got one wheel on the front. Right, let's get round there and see if we can hammer someone. I'll be alright if I'm turning left, because it puts all the weight on my right wheels. Get a slide on. Yeah, putting the brakes on didn't really help. I'm going to be in the circle. That should help. You think you're safe up there on the hill, but you're really not, buddy. Right, let's get in. We should make it quicker. Since I'm badly damaged anyway, I might as well. Hey! Right, who's attacking me? I can't get that guy up there. Yeah! Look, 100%! Already. That's how that's done. I don't even really do much. But you can see how much cooler it is with people. It's just so much more awesome. Now look, I'll show you one of my... I got medium wheels steering. Get the wheels. Victory. Yeah, so as you can see, right. Now, you can do this thing. If I go to repair, there's... Nah, don't worry about that. Okay, it's down here. Right, so I've got trailer puke, which is my original... terrible looking vehicle, but it was really good. And then I've got the Buganon, So I'll take that for a test drive. I'll show you what how cool this vehicle is. This has the 20mm autocannon on the top, and it turns pretty slowly. But look at the damage on this absolute badass of a weapon. Now, if you can get it sideways. Insane damage. It still takes ages to blow up a car, though. Unfortunately, I need to work on the vehicles. But how cool is that? I've got a bug with blades on the front and a 20mm autocannon on the top. I just found that, unfortunately, everyone aimed in the middle of your car, and before long, the central stack would get destroyed and my cannon would be gone, and then the bug was pretty much useless. So unfortunately, it wasn't a fantastic vehicle. I need more armor, but I'm limited to the parts that I've managed to loot so far, and that's not very much. Still love it, though. It looks so badass. So there's that one, and then there's the one which you saw in the previous video where I have, like, insane shotgun damage as well. And the shotguns are pretty good, but they just don't fire often enough. You've just got to circle. There's no melee weapons on this one either, though. Ow, shotgun. Madness. Probably better than the vehicle I'm currently using, so I'm going to load that one. Yeah. Mad vehicle. So, that's raids, and that's the faction. Let me show you one more faction vehicle, because I absolutely just think they're the best thing in the game at the moment, these faction vehicles. Let me show you all and go to the Wanderer. Look at this flipping vehicle. It has a minigun on the front. I spent a little time yesterday going through all of these vehicles, and I was just like, they are so mad. It's insane damage. Now watch the gun. The gun spins up first. Watch. I just think that is the geekiest thing in the world, and I love it. Oh man, I cannot wait to get my hands on a minigun in the final thing. It's gonna be nuts. I love it. How cool are these vehicles, though? I mean, you can build these yourself, obviously. I'm not going to be joining these factions specifically for these vehicles. But when you get these parts, they're going to be insane. And I love it. I just need to get to level 10. And hopefully by the next video, I will be level 10. And I will be able to show you the first lot of the gear that you get from the Lunatics. Let's have a look. Well, what was it? Lunatics! So at level 10, I get to join the Lunatics. Oh no, it says here, the reputation level 10 with engineers is required. So actually, I can join any of these, so I'll probably join Scavengers, because even their first video, I mean, look at this. Even their first vehicle, which is obviously using some of the parts that you've already got. It's flipping nuts. It just nearly knocks itself over. There is no way I'm not buying this vehicle when I can. Guys, that's it for Crossout today. If you like this vehicle, please get like and subscribe. And if you want me to do a specific video detailing all of the different faction vehicles, then please let me know. I'm happy to do that for you guys, but I need to know if you'd watch that. If you did, please get like and subscribe. Let me know in the comments, and I will see you in the next one. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.